Hello everyone, and welcome back to my studio! As you could see it already from the thumbnail and of course from the title of this video, today we are going to test different kinds of watercolor pencils, trying to find the very best one suitable for customizing dolls. Because you know, I've been sitting here on YouTube already for 3 years repainting dolls, and after all these long 3 years, I've tried actually just 3 brands of pencils. I've started with Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer, then afterwards I've tried also Caran d'Ache Supercolor Soft pencils, and I love them so much, they seemed so much better than Faber-Castell to me, that I've started to question really everything. I've started to question if the Faber-Castell pencils are really that good. And I've tried also Arteza pencils, I've made a collaboration with them a couple of months ago, and yeah, their pencils are also quite decent quality, especially for the price. But that's it! And you know, after seeing such a big difference between Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer pencils and Caran d'Ache Supercolor ones, I've started to get really curious about trying more pencil brands, because I really want to find the very best ones on the market. Because I can tell you guys, using right and very good art supplies is extremely important, even if you are just trying this new hobby. Because I perfectly know how it goes, been there, done that, now I'm going to tell you how it works and what is the result. So, you see for example somewhere on YouTube this new doll customizing hobby, and you think, oh yeah, I might be able to do it as well. Then you decide to try it, you open some tutorials on YouTube, some, I don't know, lists of supplies, and you see, first of all I need this quite expensive and quite difficult to buy Mr. Super Clear sealant, and you really must have it. And you also must have a box of watercolor pencils. And if you go look at the prices for professional brands watercolor pencils, you will see that a big box, no, some, I don't know, 72 colors or even 60 colors, it's gonna cost you more than 100 euro probably. And then you think like, no, wait, what am I supposed to pay 200-300 euro, because you still need to have dolls, you still need to have doll hair, soft pastels, acrylics, all that stuff. So you're thinking, no, I'm not going to pay 200-300 euro just to try this new hobby, and then I'm probably gonna fail in it. No, it's a little bit too big investment. I'm going to buy that box of cheaper watercolor pencils. Okay, no problem, you're buying a box of cheaper watercolor pencils, pay some, I don't know, 20 euro for it, and then you start drawing, and it all doesn't work like it should, and then you start to freak out, and then you say, no, this hobby is nothing for me, it's for people with talent, I'm nothing in it, I'm done, thank God I didn't invest 300 euro in it. But the fact is that you failed in it, because you've used bad art supplies. Because for example with a very pigmented, very soft professional pencil, you can really easily draw a line. And if you're taking some cheaper brand, the pencils are harder, the pigmentation is lower, and you have to repeat this line again and again to make it visible. And in the end, your eyes or whatever lips, it all looks dirty because it's really outlined 25 times to make it more pigmented and more visual. But in reality, the problem was not in you and not in your hands, not in your lack of talent. The problem was in the wrong art supplies. And that's why I've bought here a whole bunch of pencils, and now we're going to test them all. I have here 8 different brands. I made really complete research online on different forums, different video tutorials, talked to some of our doll artist colleagues here from YouTube. We have a group chat on Instagram, so we shared eventually with each other our favorite brands. So here I have them all approximately, and now we're going to test them. And first of all, of course, I'm going to introduce our contestants. I'm going to start, of course, with this Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer pencils. It was my very first box of pencils. It was a gift from my husband because, as I told you, I thought it was a little bit too expensive just to try to test myself if I can do doll customizing. So my husband was so sweet that he bought this box of pencils for me as a gift. The box is actually empty and the pencils you can see here in these holders. So, Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer. Then I have my Caran d'Ache Supercolor soft pencils, the ones that I really love. I have here this box of 12 pencils, and there I have also about 15 pencils, mostly brownish, you know, such nude colors that I've bought just per piece, per pencil. So, and then I've also got this box of Caran d'Ache Prisma Law watercolor pencils. So these ones were Caran d'Ache Supercolor Soft. They are professional, premium quality. It's really like the most professional line of this brand. And Caran d'Ache Prisma Law, they're more like creative studio quality, but I see them really very often recommended on different forums by different doll artists, so it seems like many people really use these pencils for working on their dolls. So it will be very interesting to test, and it will also be very interesting to test these two different like series of the same brand. They're both from the Caran d'Ache brand, but different lines. Then I've bought also a box of Stabilo aquacolor. I don't know if I'm pronouncing the brand correctly. I'll call it Stabilo, but maybe it's Stabilo, I don't know, Stable, I don't know. So Stabilo aquacolor pencils. They're also quite affordable, and I also see them quite often being recommended on different forums. So, and this is a set of 24 colors. Then I have a disaster. This is what I've told you about when I didn't want to pay a lot of money for a box of professional pencils. I've ordered a box of watercolor pencils on AliExpress. It's the same like Wish. It's a Chinese website where they sell basically absolutely everything and for some very low money. But the quality is, of course, quite often questionable. Sometimes you can get really nice things, and sometimes the only thing you can do is just throw it away. So first I've ordered this set of pencils, but I didn't want to pay a lot of money for the professional ones. But I was waiting for them to arrive for 3 or 4 weeks or something like this, and then my husband made this beautiful gift and bought this box of Faber-Castell pencils for me. So the fact is, I've never tested these pencils on dolls. I've tested them on paper ones, but that's it, never on dolls. So I'm really curious about these pencils, if they're even going to work, because this box costs something like 16 euro or something like this. Then we have here this box of Arteza. I already reviewed these pencils in one of my older videos, so if you want to, you can go there and check it out. But yeah, these pencils are absolutely okay. They really work quite nicely, and they cost not much. The only problem with them is that you cannot really buy single pencils. Like, for example, white and black and some nude and some brown. These pencils, of course, I'm buying much, 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 much more often than green, blue, and even red ones. So this is the minus point, that you always have to buy the set of 72 colors. Then I've bought this box of Kohinoor pencils. I don't know also how to pronounce it. Kohinoor. Let's call them Kohinoor pencils. There are 36 colors, and they're also very affordable. I've seen them online, and I had to buy them because 36 colors for this really low price, I thought it was an amazing deal. And I remember the Kohinoor pencils still from my childhood. They were supposed to be very good. Here I have this absolutely gorgeous box of Derwent. I should have prepared a little bit better for this video. Google the names, how to pronounce it. I know I say Derwent myself. So, and this is such a gorgeous wooden box with 72 watercolor pencils inside. I was not actually planning to buy such a big box, but strangely enough, the price difference between this box, wooden box of 72 colors, and such a simple iron box, just like this, with 24 colors, the difference was just two times. This box was just 2 times more expensive than the small box. So of course I've decided to pay the big one, especially because this is probably the most recommended kind of watercolor pencils nowadays on the market. Really, almost all my colleagues, doll artists, almost all of them are using Derwent Ink 10s nowadays. So I'm really excited to try these pencils, and I really love this pretty box. I'm so happy I've got it in this beautiful box. But anyway, pencils, you better be good, because I paid quite a lot for you. Anyway, I have quite good feelings about these pencils, so I think we can start testing. So I've prepared here already 8 colors from each brand, and now we're going to start testing them on paper, trying to see the difference, which pencils are better, which ones are worse, and stuff like this. I've tried to find, of course, more or less matching colors, but in some smaller pencil sets, like here for example, I didn't have that much choice, so a little bit there can be difference in colors. So, and here I have already prepared such a palette. So first we're going to fill it in with dry pencils, and then later I'm going to apply a little bit of water, because it's watercolor pencils, and we're going to test their watercolor abilities, watercolor effect. Well, and you see how my black and white Faber-Castell pencils look. Yeah, of course, I used them already for many years, and this is not even the first generation of black and white pencils. This is probably already, I don't know, the third pencil of each color for sure. And of course, these pencils are very good pigmented. There is no pigmentation problem in these pencils. They're not the softest on the market, I can tell you honestly, but you can perfectly use them for working on dolls. I still use them already for 3 years as my kind of basic go-to pencils. So, and now let's move to the Caran d'Ache Supra Color pencils. Yeah, you see, this color is just kind of thicker. They're softer and they're creamier. This is the difference. And of course, when you are working on doll faces sprayed with Mr. Super Clear, it's easier to work with very soft pencils that don't scratch the surface. It's quite important. So, and I'm very curious to compare this Caran d'Ache Supra Color pencils to another Caran d'Ache brand, and this is Caran d'Ache Prisma Law pencils. They're also, by the way, pretty creamy, but they also feel a little bit like more dry. It's some strange feeling. The yellow is a little bit less pigmented, but the gray and the blue, I would say, even better than Faber-Castell. Okay, now I want to compare this, like, more studio quality, cheaper pencils to another, more like also studio quality brand, and this is Stabilo. Oh, and they're also so pigmented. They're very soft, very pigmented. So I can tell you can trust all the recommendations on the internet. They're all really good. I can tell they're also better than Faber-Castell, I think. Come on, what I was using for 3 years here. And look at this brown. Really nice. Now let's test this Arteza pencils. And you see immediately, I filled in already so much colors and they didn't crumble at all. And here I get crumbles immediately. Yes, this is what I've noticed when I tested Arteza the first time. When you make them sharp, they really start to break and they start to crumble. You see, again, crumbles. That's also nice black, by the way. The best one is still this Stabilo, and the worst one is Faber-Castell, strangely enough. So, and now let's move to the potential outsiders, to these pencils from AliExpress. I don't expect much of them, but anyway, you know, for science, it's very interesting to test it anyway. So far, you see, they draw. But they're very hard, really, like, very hard. I already have pain in my hand because I really need to push very hard. And now we still have two new brands for me. I've never tried Kohinoor watercolor pencils and I've never tried Derwent pencils, so I'm extremely curious about them. So let's test. Oh, they're also super soft and super creamy. Oh, the black, look how smooth it is. Nice, nice, nice. You know, I would say this is the best pencil so far. So, and now it's finally time for the Derwent pencils. I'm really extremely curious about them. So, let's try. Whew. Hello, gray. I don't have to push at all. This pencil goes just from itself. I think if I push, it will become just black. Yep. Oh my god, and this is the lightest gray from the box. Of course, you can go quite light with it. But if you push harder, it will become simply black. Wow. That's the pigmentation. Hello. So now let's take a look at all these colors applied dry and make some first conclusions. So for me, the best are Derwent, Kohinoor, and I really like the Stabilo pencils. Really, as in a dry condition, these three are the best, but really Kohinoor and Derwent are the best. Look at these two blacks, they're much more black than all other blacks. This brown, it looks really like cream. The red coverage is amazing. The blue, really amazing. But now I'm going to apply some water here to this half colored sections. And we're going to see how it's going to color the complete section. How much pigment is in these pencils? Is it enough to cover like the complete section? And how intense this color is going to be? And look at their vent. Look at it. Look at it. Yeah, they're called Inktense, and water indeed turns it just straight into ink. And meanwhile, just the blue from AliExpress doesn't show no magic at all. So this is our finished color chart, and I think the results are pretty clear. Derwent is the winner of this competition together with Kohinoor. I don't know, probably Derwent is still more pigmented and even more creamy, but they're very comparable, really. All the colors are very comparable, and this is a very surprising result for me. The Faber-Castell pencils that I've used for 3 years as my main pencil set are performing approximately as bad as AliExpress. So that was the first part of our experiment, and I can tell you it was already very interesting. But of course, drawing on paper and drawing on dolls, it's not the same, because this rubber doll face is there, it's quite a specific surface. Even after we're sealing it with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant to give it some tooth, you know, to make it more matte to be able to draw on it, it's still not the same like drawing on paper. That's why it's very important to test our pencils on dolls. So, I've bought here 4 doll hats. They're actually supposed to be the same. I've ordered them like the same, but you know, it's AliExpress, it's ordering from China, and that's why 3 hats are actually the same, and the 4th one is a little bit different. But anyway, for us it doesn't matter today, the face mold. The skin tone is very important, and the skin tone is the same. So I've already sprayed these faces with 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant, and you see I've tagged here already the pencil brand names to, you know, to not be lost in our experiment. So now let's start. My goal on the first layer is to sketch the faces and to draw shadows with pastels after all. And I'm going to use pencils in exactly the same order like we just tested them on paper. It will be easier for us to remember. So I'm going to start with Faber-Castell and Caran d'Ache Supra Color. Both of these pencils, I know they work really good on those, but Faber-Castell is of course a little bit hard. But anyway, you can see that it draws quite good on this doll's face. But Caran d'Ache Supra Color, like I told you already, I like much more, and you can see it immediately why. I can easily draw a very fine line, I don't have to push on this pencil, and it's really soft enough, and the color payoff is much better than from Faber-Castell. The second face I will draw using Caran d'Ache Prismalaw and Stabilo pencils. And let's start with the Caran d'Ache Supra Color younger sister, Caran d'Ache Prismalaw. Oh no, no, I don't like it at all. The difference is really huge between these two kinds of Caran d'Ache pencils. This one is very hard and it kind of doesn't want to draw, it doesn't go on. I don't know, I have to repeat the same lines again and again and again, and as a result I get a very dirty looking drawing with very thick lines. Nope guys, I don't like it at all. Now let's try the Stabilo pencils on another side. Yes, they're much better than Prismalaw. They work really good on a doll face, really. I like it, I like the result they give. And on this third face, we're going to test the 2 Chinese brands, Arteza, and also these pencils from AliExpress. Arteza pencils I've tried already once or twice on my dolls, and they draw really good on dolls. You can perfectly work with them, but this is what I told you when we tried them on paper. This pencil's quite crumbly, this top breaks and you can see these tiny crumbles around. So the pencils from AliExpress are the next to be tested, and no guys, no, they're way too hard and they're not enough pigmented. Yeah, you can draw with them, of course, that's it, but it all looks just dirty. And And on the last phase, I'm going to test our current winners, Kohinoor and Derwent pencils. And let's start with Kohinoor. And yes, the color goes quite easily on, but I honestly think that on paper they performed more impressive. And the top of this pencil has also been broken already, but I've noticed this crumbling already when we colored the chart. And now let's finally test our champion at the moment, the Derwent pencils. And yes guys, they're just on another level than the rest of the pencils. It really feels and performs like a soft eye pencil, really. And I apply absolutely zero pressure on this pencil, really, not even a little bit, otherwise the lines would become even too thick. But the very sharp top broke off as well, by the way. In this case, it's really from softness, I would say. So now let's take a look at the layer one, and I don't know guys, I think we have already the winner. We can finish the experiment and just go home. I don't know, I'm kidding. We will of course continue because we have to know what are the second best pencils, because I don't know, to me Derwent is just playing in another league. But anyway, for now I really also like the results shown by Caran d'Ache Supracolor, Stabilo and Kohinoor. And Arteza also looks quite okay. So now I will quickly apply a layer or two of shadows using brown pastels on all these faces, and then we will continue testing the pencils. Okay, now it's time to add more color to her face, and now we'll finally know what is the best white pencil on the market. Because really, having a very good white color and a good black color, it's really essential. Well, the white from Faber-Castell I know very well, it's quite basic, normal, I don't know, I used to apply 3 layers of it when I used it as my main white pencil, but anyway, it's not the best white on the market. The next one is Caran d'Ache Supracolor, and this white I like much more. This is my main white pencil at the moment, and I usually apply 2 layers of it to reach really like the perfect coverage. And you can see it immediately that this pencil is much more pigmented than Faber-Castell. Okay, now let's try Caran d'Ache Prismaloy again. I didn't like the brown pencil at all, but maybe the other colors will be a little bit better. Nope. The white is also very poor and the pencil is also very hard, so no, this is not a good white. And the other colors from this brand are also so-so, let's be honest. Now let's check the Stabilo pencils. And you can see the difference immediately, you see? It's quite a nice white color, by the way, and it's very similar to Supracolor, and it feels nice, so Stabilo really like good points, and for the brown, and for the white. Okay, Arteza time, yeah, this white is also quite nice, these pencils, yeah, they just perform good again. So the next are the pencils from AliExpress. I don't know what to say here. Well, these pencils draw. This is what I can say. But of course, you will have to apply probably 10 or 20 layers of this white to reach more or less decent coverage. Now let's take finally the last phase and try the white from Kohinoor first. And it's quite a normal average white, nothing really special. You see how important it was to test it on dolls? because I absolutely love these pencils on paper, but on those they really don't show anything special. They are not bad, of course, but they are not the best here in the range. And now it's finally time for the white from Derwent. I still don't know how to pronounce it, guys. But anyway, it's a predictably very good white pencil. It's for sure one of the best in our today's selection. So, what is the conclusion after this layer? I think the white from Supracolor looks the best now. I also absolutely love how looks the white from Arteza. Derwent looks, of course, very nice, but honestly, I cannot say it beats all the other pencils. And the white from Stabilo, it looks also very good. The side from AliExpress pencils, it looks extremely poor. There is nothing to say, really. I also don't like the white from Prismalaw, and I'm extremely disappointed in Faber-Castell at the moment. They're one of the most recommended pencils online, and they cost a lot, and they perform on those just like some cheap pencils. So now I'm going to repeat this layer again. I always do it to reach the best coverage of the white, and then we will compare the faces one more time. So this is how it looks after applying two layers of white, and now you can already clearly see the difference between the leaders and the outsiders of our competition. So now let's draw everything more detailed, add shadows, highlights, some tiny details, lashes, and then we will take a final look at the dolls. So here are the finished faces, and I think I'm kinda ready to share my final thoughts and to call the winner of this competition. So of course, the most of all, I like the results shown by Derwent Inktense pencils and Karandash Supracolor Soft. Really, the pigmentation of these pencils is absolutely amazing. They're extremely soft, you don't have to push like on your pencil or repeat the same line 10 times trying to get more pigment. No, everything goes super smooth and easy on. So I would say Derwent Inktense and Karandash Supercolor. But since the Derwent pencils have also won the paper testing part of our competition today, I would of course call Derwent pencils the winner of this test, because really, they work beautifully and on dolls and on paper, super soft, super pigmented, really amazing pencils. But you can see that with the Karandash Supercolor, I could draw also absolutely nice face. Then I also like the result shown by Stabilo pencils, and I absolutely didn't like the result shown by Prismalo pencils, because you can see the difference even on the eyelashes. You see, on this side, on the side of Stabilo pencils, the eyelashes are really separated, very sharp, very good visible, and here they're like, are there the eyelashes? Should I maybe draw them again? Because they're not that black, not that fine, they're quite thick. I don't know, I don't like. And also the irises, you see here is lots of details with yellow pencil made, and here, yeah, you can see almost nothing. I also quite like the Arteza pencils. No, quite like, I really like the way they perform. It's a very good result. I have just nothing to say about the AliExpress pencils. No, yeah, what I can say. Don't use them for doll customizing. You're going to be disappointed. Kohinoor pencils, yeah, they're quite nice, but here's also a little bit of problem that they're too soft, a little bit too crumbly, and pigment doesn't go that perfect on these rubber doll faces. You also can see quite thick eyelashes, the detailization is a little bit like blurry. So, and here we still have my Faber-Castell pencils left. You know, they didn't perform good. I didn't like the white pencil. I don't know, they performed kind of less than the other brands. But after all, I think we could get a very pretty eye. I don't know. Probably because these pencils are pretty hard, it's really easy to draw such details like lashes, for example. So, after all, you know, I was really so mad at these Faber-Castell pencils throughout the complete experiment. Like, the complete day, I was just mad at these pencils that they perform bad. But no, after all, I quite like the end result. But you saw it, they're not the easiest pencils to use. So, and here is finally the winner of our competition. You cannot even imagine, guys, how happy I am now that I bought this very big and pretty box of these pencils. I'm going to have a lot of fun with it, I'm sure. So guys, and that was our experiment for today. I really hope it was useful for you, because for me it was extremely useful today. And I would also love to ask you for some more recommendations. Maybe you know more brands of very good quality watercolor pencils that could be used potentially on dolls. And I would also love to ask your opinion about these kind of videos when we are not straight repainting dolls, customizing dolls, but when we are trying something else, testing something else. Maybe in the future I'm planning also to do some other kinds of art here on my YouTube channel. Of course, don't worry, dolls will not disappear, but maybe like once per month we could do something else. I don't know, some theoretical things, testing things, I don't know, doing other kinds of art. So I'm waiting for all kinds of your ideas. I'm open for discussion. And thank you so much for your attention today. Please don't forget to support my videos on YouTube with your likes, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and I will see you already very soon, next week Friday. And next week we are going to repaint a doll. So, see you next week Friday. Love you guys. Bye.